Up next in Eyewitness News, those who made the ultimate sacrifice defending the red, white, and blue are never forgotten.
We felt like it was important to show our support on Memorial Day.
On a sunny Memorial Day morning, we as a nation remembered and honored those who gave their lives so others could live freely. Good afternoon, I'm Renee Passal. Services like that took place across the Northland, but in Gary, New Duluth, a living World War II vet is being honored for his steadfast remembrance of our fallen heroes. Our reporter Travis Dill brings us the story.
The rifle salute echoes around the Veterans Memorial in Gary, New Duluth, as nearly 200 residents gather for Memorial Day. Steve Bolich helped lead the service.
We will continue to honor those who have fallen.
He saw the sacrifice paid by the fallen during his deployment in World War II.
I was kamikaze to the Philippines, lost many of my shipmates, fortunate to survive. But this has happened all over America, so they should remember that somebody paid a price for us to enjoy today.
His Navy service and leadership in the VFW helped him rally the community to remember the cost. He instilled the same value in his family.
We think that recognition of service, recognition of community involvement, and recognition of honoring the fallen by practicing your faith openly is all part of what America is about. My father is a true patriot, and that's how he raised us.
So Mayor Don Ness proclaims today as Steve Bolich Day. His neighbors rejoice, but Bolich is humbled.
To me, it was quite an honor because I just didn't expect them to name May 26th. The only thing is, you don't expect it, you know, you're not overly prepared for it.
He may be at a loss for words, but his daughter says the respect for her father and fallen veterans strengthens Gary, New Duluth.
This community will continue to thrive and represent what is best about America, and I have never forgotten my roots.
A younger group has taken over the neighborhood memorial, and Bolich is proud of them for following in his footsteps.
They're in good hands. They've done a great job to honor the Iraq veterans and the Afghanistan veterans.
More military heroes will pay the ultimate sacrifice, but they will never be forgotten in Gary, New Duluth. This is Travis Dill for Eyewitness News.
We will continue to honor those who have fallen.
Across the Northland on this Memorial Day, we remember the men and women who gave everything for their country.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Alan Hoagland. Darren has the night off. Well, services to honor fallen heroes are happening all over the Northland this Memorial Day. But one World War II veteran is getting some special recognition from his neighbors in Gary, New Duluth. Our reporter Travis Dill brings us this story.
Gary, New Duluth has been through some rough times, and the Veterans Memorial off Highway 23 shows what our nation's wars have cost these neighborhoods. So nearly 200 residents gather to respect the sacrifice of their fallen heroes.
This community will continue to thrive and represent what is best about America, and I have never forgotten my roots.
This is my dad.
Joni Bolich says her father, Steve Bolich, instilled that respect in her, and he rallied the community to support veterans.
We think that recognition of service, recognition of community involvement, and recognition of honoring the fallen by practicing your faith openly is all part of what America is about. My father is a true patriot, and that's how he raised us.
Bolich served in the Navy during World War II and says what he saw pushed him to lead the community.
I was kamikaze to the Philippines, lost many of my shipmates, fortunate to survive. But this has happened all over America, so they should remember that somebody paid a price for us to enjoy today.
He later led the local VFW and became respected throughout the community. So after the memorial service, Mayor Don Ness proclaimed today Steve Bolich Day. His neighbors rejoice, but Bolich remains humble.
To me, it was quite an honor because I just didn't expect them to name May 26th. The only thing is, you don't expect it, you know, you're not overly prepared for it.
A younger group has taken over the neighborhood memorial, and Bolich is proud of them for following in his footsteps.
They're in good hands. They've done a great job to honor the Iraq veterans and the Afghanistan veterans.
More military heroes will pay the ultimate sacrifice, but they will never be forgotten in Gary, New Duluth. This is Travis Dill for Eyewitness News.
Closer to home now, services to honor fallen heroes happened all over the Northland today, but one World War II veteran is getting special recognition from his neighbors in Gary, New Duluth. Steve Ballage served in the Navy during World War II. He later led the local VFW and became respected throughout the community. After a memorial service today, Mayor Don Ness proclaimed it Steve Ballage Day. Through it all, Steve remains humble.
I was kamikaze to the Philippines. Lost many of my shipmates. Fortunate to survive. But this has happened all over America, so they should remember that somebody paid a price for us to enjoy today.
We all went to different ships and participated in the rest of it, but the going on active duty together from one town together has been significant and held us together all these years. This was the first bunch called on active duty. Fortunately, the training we got on the Paducah provided us, because many of us went all over the world fighting later on. In fact, if you took a check on every one of those guys, every one of us have been overseas in a different direction later on.
The North Atlantic is the worst waters in the world. And anybody can survive up there, I take my hat off. Well, it is terrible.
Running convoys there was terrible.
It's terrible.
Yeah,
I ran. It didn't fight just the enemy, but the environment was terrible.
And we went through the Panama Canal, got to Bora Bora, got to Hollandia, New Guinea, in time for the invasion of the Philippines. And I'll never forget the first kamikaze I saw. I said, this is not like the Atlantic. This is a different war. But in the Pacific, kamikazes didn't care. In fact, later on in the war, I was kamikazed in Battle of Ormoc Bay.